Now we have Bandy here from Chaospot Essen, and he's going to show us how we can hide our data when we really need to hide. So have fun with Bandy.
Hi, I'm speaking about my project Pampanic. It's about 9 months old now. I tell you what I'm speaking about today. This is what I'm speaking about a very old problem. How this project tries to solve this problem in some way. A little crash course about Lux, this encryption system in Linux. How Pampanic will interact with Lux. How it might help you in some situations and when it can't help you. And I show a live demo how to configure it and destroy a VM. So this old problem is us being the security hole. You might know this XKCD comic, which shows exactly this. But the question here is, how do we get out of this situation? For Linux PAM, I had some ideas. Getting out of this at some grade. Maybe you should know. PAM is the authentication module thing which asks for username and password. And I put my little project in there to interact with Linux authentication things. So, how do we get out of it? We should make some assumptions about the environment. We have to live in a constitutional state because then we have the ability to deny things. Because this project is builds on the deniability. Also, you should encrypt your system. If you use Ubuntu, for example, you just tick the box for system encryption, and you've got Lux. Pampanic offers to set two passwords, and/or two GPT formatted devices as in USB dongle or SD cards, if you wish. Those are used as authentication, and the question is why two? You may can read. one is for authentication, though the other one is to destroy the key slots in Lux. What is a key slot in Lux? I made this nice thing here. We've got the big master key. It's the black big one. We've got the 8 slots. That's the rainbow colored things here. Those are used. Those key slots are for the user. So the user uses its key, maybe a password, maybe something else. If you're an advanced user, you know how to configure it. This is used to unlock the encrypted master key, which is then used to decrypt the Lux container. Yeah, that's how it works. This is how Lux looks like on the hard drive. We've got the partition header here. And there's some information about how the master key is, what modes are used for the master key, the cipher mode, the key length, and some other stuff. And also some key metric slot information. That's the keys for the user. And they say how to decrypt the master key also. We've got the key metric slots. That's what I said, the user slots. You can have till 8, as I said. And we've got the bulk data. That is the
yeah, the container where all those encrypted stuff, the system is in, and yeah, that's how it works. So when we want to look out the bad guys, Panpanic will execute crypt setup blocks erase, which I looked up in the source code. It actually puts some it makes some random data and makes sure that it's not that you can't get those keys back, and that's a good thing, and that's what Panpanic is using. And yeah, if you want to be sure that you can back up those things, you should make a looks header backup. It's maybe it's about 2 megabytes of data. Yeah, and doesn't fit on the floppy disk, but yeah. yeah, what might help? I'm quoting Udo Vetter from an earlier talk, where the police tried to stress the raided ones, saying, hey, give us a password of your encrypted file system, or yeah, the forensics will get it anyway, so give it. No. Nice try. Also, being forced to type or tell your password, like on borders. I've never been to the US, but I heard that's common practice there. What won't help is cold boot attacks, people making your device without any electricity and put some freezing stuff in there. And yeah, you know the attack, I guess. That's the part of the of my presentation. I will now make the live demo. Come on. Ah. My password here is ASDF, so you know. I've installed Panpanic via an Ubuntu PPA. We've got a fancy logo, which is not that fancy. and I've got this configuration program using bash menu dialog. So you have the ability to use a media devices or password. I will do media devices because to show how the media device things work. I fixed it a few days ago because it didn't work after another big bug fix I did. So yeah. So I've got to. Where is it? Asleep. So I've got this in the configuration cache now. I put in the panic device. I've got here the device for authentication, and here's the device for the panic, issuing the panic. So this question here is about destroying the thing. You could also say, don't destroy it, just reboot. We will destroy it. We don't make a header backup because we don't need it here in this session. Also, I will issue a reboot here. A strict mode is like if the Pampani configuration is corrupt, it doesn't let you in. It doesn't let you log into your system. So here are some hints how to integrate it in your PAM config. So we need another terminal. In Ubuntu, I have this common auth and common account thing. Common auth. Just put it here. Oops. First include, of course. And the account part. I don't know why they put those things apart. So now we have saved our configuration. It's active. So the first thing you will see is the question after the key. If you use a password, it will say password. So I'm using the key for authentication. Of course, I've got to put it through the VM again, which is very annoying, to be honest. I would press enter, and it doesn't work because it's not there. Yeah, no, it's there. So ASDF, and I'm in. I'll do it again, and then the VM will have a destruction thing, and you will see. So I put in the panic key, the panic dongle, press enter. Oh, I should again put this through here. So it seems to work now, and it reboots. ASDF, and I successfully destroyed my VM, and I'm done. So this was it. There's some time left for Q&A if you have some questions.
Thank you, Bandy. Have some applause again. So if you have any questions, please come to the microphones in the room. Yes, please.
Thank you for this. What do you think would be a more advanced method to secure your system against a cold start? Because this is like the middle solution. Mm-hmm. Between somehow securing it and not securing it at all.
Mm-hmm. There's a way to put some Linux, some arguments to let the system make some. It's called memory poisoning. It will put some stuff in the memory which. A bit of secures your system to put out the RAM and read it. So it will make some some random data into the RAM and makes your RAM not readable to cold boot attacks. At least if you don't, if you they don't pull your device away, of course.
Next, I would ask the Signal Angel. Do we have questions from the internet?
The internet is not distressed and has no questions.
Probably still asleep. Okay, then to my left, please.
Hello. Thank you for your talk, which has been very nicely presented. But in your system, the attacker knows that you gave him wrong information because afterwards the information is gone. He gets a very obvious error message that no data is present anymore. What do you suggest, how much work would it be to, after destroying the original partition, have a decoy partition with some not so sensitive data on it?
Yeah, you could do such things, of course. You also have the ability to configure looks that way, but you have to do it manually, that you have a partition where just your system is unencrypted, for example, or you have an encrypted. Or it doesn't matter. So, for example, you have a root file system and a home file system. You can configure Panpanic that way that you can just destroy the home partition, for example. So that's an example of how it could work.
Okay, and then another one on the right.
Is this forensically, do they see what you've done? Is it either written like a random new key that you do not know, or is it like just random data? Is it forensically determined that you don't know the key, or that you've actually messed with the system and therefore might have tampered with evidence?
Yeah, you mean the Lux destruction mm-hmm. part? Well, it's part of Lux itself, so it just puts some random data in the small Lux key thing. I read about some special destruction parts. I'm not sure about this, but it's, well, I understand it and as I've read the source code, it's okay and secure. I don't know if it answers your question.
Not really. Is it distinguishable from a normal key that would have been in there?
Is it distinguishable from a normal key that would be in the Lux header, the random data?
No. So, yeah.
That was my question. Thank you.
So, if random, destruction was done, there was a Lux header. It sees the Lux header. It's okay. I've got Lux here, and it doesn't. It can't read the keys anymore. So that's the part here. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, any other questions? I don't see any, so let's have some thank you applause again.